partner and I made it to the Brooklyn Museum for the opening weekend of Giants, art from the Dean collection of Swizz Beatz and Alicia Keys. Giants is a celebration of the belief that everyone should have the opportunity to enjoy art, cultivate a relationship with creativity, and build their own artistic community. For Swizz Beatz and Alicia Keys, all artists are giants. The Dean collection reflects the couple's diverse passions, from their early acquisitions of albums, music equipment, and BMX bikes, to their present-day philosophy of by the artist, for the artist, with the people. Swizz Beatz started DJing at age 12 in his hometown, the South Bronx. Inspired by the skills and beats of older DJs, Swizz acquired several pieces of equipment from his musical mentors, including the turntables on view here. The artists in this section have left an indelible mark on the world. Their experimentation, vision, and resolve have influenced generations of artists who have followed through the doors they opened. Esther Malangu made history when she reimagined the long-standing tradition of South African Ndebele house painting. Barclay L. Hendrick's wife remarked that when he discovered those Jamaican landscapes, that was it, he was reborn. She was offering a dramatically different understanding of a painter who's known for his dapper portrayals of Black subjects. I guess it's time for a little disclaimer. I am by no means an art historian. I've just learned so much in being immersed in this exhibit. This piece was a moment. Kwaliasha Wood connects craft traditions with contemporary technology to reveal and configure how queer Black femininity is experienced both offline and online. This is an epic textile. I hope I captured it well. In this work, Hank Willis Thomas spotlights the impact of mass criminalization on Black consumerism in the United States. The legacy and political power of portrait and street photography are exemplified in the works of Kwame Brafeth and Gordon Parks. Internationally renowned photographers Malik Sidibe and Sanlay Sori documented moments of self-preservation and pride, as well as everyday life and socio-political milestones in the years that followed Mali's and Burkina Faso's independence. And here's one of my favorite parts of the entire exhibit. It's Titus Kaphar's A Puzzled Revolution. This piece depicts one of the most iconic images in American sports history. It's Muhammad Ali's 1965 phantom punch knockout of Sonny Liston. After cutting out Ali's body from the canvas, leaving only his silhouette, the artist then fills the cutout with different puzzle pieces, including a Renaissance-style portrait of the Virgin Mary. And here's a 25-foot-long Kehinde Wiley piece. Here's a picture of myself next to it, just so you understand the scale. Here's a look at Arthur Jafa's overwhelming 7,000-pound truck tire sculpture called Big Wheel One. So what did we think of the exhibit? We thought it was great. We highly recommend you to visit yourself if you can.